Thought I'd pop on with another vid. Enough stuff to cover here that looks worthwhile to share. You may have noticed we had that big 7.1 to 7.3 164 kilometer deep earthquake over here in the Sandwich Islands. It's like 0226 UTC this morning. Here it is here. Yeah, 0226 30 UTC, 150 kilometers deep. So it's about 100 miles deep, which is good for eliminating any tsunami threat or anything. But thought I'd check out the old ionospheric electric polar potential. Polar cap, because I remember Astral Traveler used to put some weight to this, or he was developing the theory on it anyway. So I said, well, let me go see what this thing looked like at the time of this earthquake. And sure enough, get like a serious double tap of a negative connection. I think it's negative. I don't know why they got the plus here, but I think blue is negative. But anyway, you see that deep, deep purple double tap connection right at 222.09. The quake happened at, and we get a lot of missing time on this thing. I'll run it through real quick for you to show you. So they're definitely hiding something. So this thing must be significant. I'm gonna have to try to maybe research it a little bit more. But so you can see there's 12:11:134 UTC. And then it jumps to 222.09. There you get the big deep purple double tap right around down by Antarctica where that quake occurred. So the double tap was like here and here. Quake was here, it was on the fault line or close to it anyway. And once again, here's the time, 226 UTC. So I thought that was interesting. And you tap it one more time, it goes to, okay, there's the 226.09. Oh, 222.02, that's when we got 0222, I'm sorry, UTC. That's when we got the double tap. Quake occurred at 0226 UTC. So if we advance it one more click, we get to the 0226. You still got the serious purple here, but things are changing as you can see quite rapidly, the connection. Then at 2:30, the deep blues and purples go away pretty much. That's after the quake. 2:34, 2:38, 2:42. Pretty much goes away completely. But look at this polar cap. Here we pulled up the last 300 frames, 8 seconds per frame, 8 frames per second. And it takes you all the way back to November 23rd. Runs up through 08, November 23rd to 10:40. Then it jumps to 11:24, 0, 120 UTC. So that's a couple hours there. Then it jumped all the way to 7. There's another 7 hours missing. Then it jumps from 8 to 13. That's 5 hours. Then on the 24th at 15:20 UTC, jumps to 11:25, double aught 20 UTC. So that's another 9 hours missing. Then we jump to 7, almost 8. That's another 8 hours. So you see what I'm talking about. Got a whole bunch of missing time in here. I'll just pull it through real quick for you because we're running out of time already. Me and I got more things to cover here. But, I mean, it just. So, this is obviously pretty significant if they're taking the time to eliminate all this time on that polar cap potential. And as you can see here, well, this is the last 3 days on ACE. Now remember, ACE is measuring the phi angle from 0 to 360 degrees, which it should be measured at, which is illustrated here on this solarham.net space weather tutorial. And the link's in the description box. And then if you want to click here, you get the L1 Lagrange point. So you get two links in one. This is where the ACE and the Discoverer reside out here at the L1 Lagrange point, about 930,000 miles in front of the planet Earth. Sun's another 92 million miles out this way. It's like an early warning system. It records all the solar data, wind stream coming from the our sun. So this phi angle, that measures the connection between Earth and the sun. That's covered down here. If it's zero, that means the angle is pointing from the Earth to the sun. If it's at 180, it's from the sun to the Earth. So as you can see here, this is the last 3 days on ACE. We've been running some crazy connections here. Looks, just picture Earth right in the middle. That's what I would say. Earth's in the middle. It's, sometimes it's connecting through that big planet to the sun. And sometimes it's connecting through that big planet in front of the Earth to Nemesis. And or all four connected together. But the connection is just bouncing back and forth between Nemesis, Earth, big planet, sun, and then vice versa, sun, big planet, Earth, and Nemesis. Cause, I mean, this is some crazy, crazy things there. I've never seen it quite like that. Now here it is on Discover. This is the last 3 days, but since they got Discover bumped from 0 to 360 up to 40 to 400, you're not seeing all these Earth connections down here. If you drag this along, it gives you the numbers. But I would submit to you that to me it looks like we're connected simultaneously. The Earth is to the sun and to Nemesis, and I'm going to show you why I say that. I pulled up the last 6 hours. Look at this. See how the phi angle's bouncing? Now, you don't get this on Discover, but on the ACE you do. This is the last 6 hours. Look how the connection's just going up and down. Then it's more of an Earth to sun connection. Then it goes up to Nemesis, which is 360. Because anything above 180 indicates its connection to some solar body behind the Earth. So that's the last 6 hours. Look at the last 2 hours. You can see it's even more pronounced. But like I said, you don't really get that on Discover. And I don't have time to show you, but take my word for it. It doesn't... It doesn't show like that on the Discover. So here we go. Guess what? Remember that video, 2 videos ago I made on the solar eclipse on the French webcam? There it is. Lavando, Cocoa Beach. And then they took that webcam down for a while. Well, the webcam's back up. And I pulled up some webcams that are in the neighborhood in the Mediterranean. There's another one And this, so the sun's over here to the west, so that would be that we're facing what? South. We're looking south, the sun would be what, to the right. If we're looking north, the sun's to the, yeah, if we're looking south, south facing camera, the sun would be to the right, to the west. This one's not loading, but here's the Cocoa Beach one again. Now, before these clouds came into the picture, it was showing just like it did the other day when I made that video. It's all darked out. I don't have time to show you everything here, but as you can see, well, I'll just pull it up for, I'll back it up. So one thing nice about this, you can back the thing up. And it looks like it's still looking pretty dark to me, guys. I don't know. There's another one in the same neighborhood, La Parada. These are all in the Mediterranean. And here's the map here, and I got them all starred where all these cameras are. See, there's the Cocoa Beach. There's the original. There's another one I got pulled up, Samina. And there's the other one. Here's the Samina one. This is on a different website, but this is also there's the sun to the left, so this will be a north facing camera, but I'm looking pretty deep blue there. But anyway, I thought I'd point that out. This cameras are back up, and I'll put the link to the Lecoq Cocoa Beach camera in the description box. Once you pull that up, you can get that YouTube channel and just subscribe, and you'll see all the different cameras. But anyway, here's the run. We got missing time starting at okay, 11:02, 11:03, 11:04, 11:05, 11:06:22. It goes up to 7. Oh wait a second, 12:10. That's when the missing time happened. Okay, missing time. Goes up 12:10, 7:22, and then it jumps to 18:58. So I thought I'd pull these up. This is kind of interesting. Here's the missing time here. 7, 12:10. This is when they cut it off. You can see we got a bunch of energy piled in. And then they cut these ones off too. So you can see it jumps from. Goes from 7, 7:40, 8:20, let it run a little bit, then 9:40, then it jumps to 21:32. That's when they cut these off. And here they, like I showed you, it went from 7:22 to 10. The missing time, and encompassed, get if the solar wind speed was way back then. I'm running out of time, so I'm trying to rush through this. Watch these solar wind speed numbers. I think we passed, yeah, that was all at the 0100 to 0152 mark. So you can see the solar wind speed's all pretty normal again. I mean, normal as can get. Pull this through for you real quick. You can still see all this stuff piling up in front. I mean, look at all these field lines. And you can see these polar cap field lines are getting pretty dark. Still got the big shoulder push out here, even more pronounced than this is pointing that way. That part of the magnetopause. So I'd say we're in like in the middle of a squeeze play, guys. Between the, we're like in between. The connections fluctuating like crazy. Polar cap potential going crazy, and they're taking away a lot of time, a lot of time on that. So I definitely got to investigate that a little bit further. Then here's geospace. Hasn't been looking too crazy. And the MLSO. They didn't give us the last 2 days. The last one we got's on the 9th. You can see the objects. Oh well, running out of time. God bless, peace, and I'm out.